Tunnel off. We have eyes in the sky. You showed real grit out there. Damn.
Last night took a L, but tonight I bounce back. Wake up every morning, by the night I count stacks. Knew that ass was real when I hit it, bounce back.
Yo, what's going on YouTube? It is your boy Ears. Hope you guys are having a great rest of your day, start your day, whatever time it may be. I feel like this video is going to help a lot of you guys out that really enjoyed my pro player tips video. A lot of you guys seem to be getting a lot of E2 rockets, increasing your KD, and overall just becoming a better Call of Duty player after watching that video. Hope you guys do enjoy this one. This one should help you guys a lot, specifically targeting players who are choking their V2 rocket streaks, maybe choking their ball turret gunners, or some players who want to learn on how to get higher kill streaks with in Call of Duty World War II or whatever Call of Duty they're playing with. Now, the first tip that I'm going to go ahead and giving you guys some insight is, number one, if you're trying to go for the higher kill streaks and you are not a good player, the first thing you guys should realize is if you keep dying off those high kill streaks, the mistake you're making is you're running too high of score streaks. Now, this is gonna go back to square one, to the basics. If you guys are just starting off playing Call of Duty, you guys obviously do not want to run the high kill streaks off the bat. You want to start off running the lower kill streaks, like the UAV, the Molotov cocktail, the glide bomb. You wanna work your way up, work on getting 3 kills in a row, 4 kills in a row, 5 kills in a row. And then, you know, every couple of days after you're getting comfortable getting those kill streaks, work your way up. Maybe you want to increase it, your highest streak from the glide bomb to maybe the artillery strike, or maybe you want to increase it to the emergency airdrop. Something along the lines of that. You need to establish some building blocks, some stepping stones, so you guys can make progress and see yourself progressing and hitting the higher kill streaks. Ever since I've been playing COD MW2, I always ran the lowest kill streaks with their UAV, care package, and predator missile. As I got better, I started to run the Harrier strike. As I got a little bit better, I started to put on the chopper gunner until I was able to hit the nuke consistently. Consistency is key, so if you guys are building your way up, running the low kill streaks first and then going ahead and, you know, progressively increasing the kill streaks you're getting on, you're going to be able to hit them a lot easier because you're going to be training your mind, okay, 5 kills, that's easy, I can easily get my predator missile. 7 kills, that's easy, I can easily get my artillery strike. You know, 11 kills, that's easy, I can, you know, get my paratroopers, and then on and on and on until you get that ball turret gunner, and then you guys can go ahead and get that V2 rocket if you're feeling a little bit freaky. Now, this is probably one of the most important tips, and I feel that this is going to help out the most because this is literally a mind game, a mind trick. You need to trick yourself into thinking that you're not really on that high of a kill streak, and as you consistently recycle your score streaks, the V2 rocket or whatever BOAB streak you're trying to get will just pop up, and you're going to get it like, oh man, I got it. You know, I played smart, I pieced it together slowly, I stayed consistent, I'm, you know, didn't miss any shots, I was staying calm, and you'll be able to get your V2 rocket streaks a lot easier. I guarantee you that. The second tip you guys want to keep in account and use is you're playing too fast. So many people I see just bum rushing the spawn, running, you know, into 5 people at once. The number one thing you don't want to do in COD World War II, especially on this game, is you don't want to run into multiple enemies at once if you're trying to go on long kill streaks. You want to play, like I said in my previous video, the outskirts of the map. You want to pick people off from the sides, from the back, from an elevated position on a heglitch. You need to be playing smart. Let players come to you, because people, I'm going to be having another tip in this video, people are going to be going for those revenge kills, and those are the people that you're going to be killing over and over and over again on how you get your V2. If you're staying in one spot for too long, move, switch positions. People are going to be, you know, trying to get that revenge kill. You're going to shoot them from behind, move another spot, you're going to shoot them from another side. It's just, you know, shifting your spots, rotating the spawns is the number one tip that you can do to get your V2 rocket. I cannot tell you guys that enough, man. It's helped me out so many times to get V2s. It's helped you guys out a lot. I know a lot of you guys who come back commenting on my videos saying, yo dude, your rotating spawns tip, I watch your videos, I watch how you play, it's been helping me get on long streaks. A lot of people for some reason consider that camping. I really don't understand that. Now, this is going to be going into my third tip. Rotating the spawns is not camping. There's absolutely nothing wrong, especially if you're playing free-for-all, locking down a side of the map. Keep in mind, I'm not saying camping a building, a side of the map or an area of the map, and making it your home, predicting the spawns, and just people having people on lock and just knowing where people are going to be generally coming from. That is the basic square run tip and tricks, the best way on how you guys can increase your KD, get your V2 rockets, and overall become a better player. Like I'm saying, there's literally nothing wrong about locking an area down and playing smart. The people who are complaining about calling that camping, the people who are complaining are, you know, about people, you know, playing slow, those are the players who are running requisitions, those are the players who are getting V2 rockets dropped on them, and those are the players who are ultimately quitting the series because they don't think about what they're doing. They just go running around like a headless chicken. And these are the players that you need in your lobbies. These are the players that we're getting V2 rockets on. These are the players that we're getting our ball turn gunners on. These are the players that are allowing us to increase our KD. You guys need to think smart. Get out of that box. Get out of that mindset. I don't know where that came from, where playing smart and locking down an area is considered camping. Probably from some players who are just terrible at the game and they have no idea what they're talking about. I'm telling you guys this right now. Locking down an area is not camping. Patrolling an area is not camping. Playing smart and rotating the spawns is not camping. Sitting in a building with Bettys behind yourself, that is camping. Don't do that. That will not get you better. But I'm telling you guys this. Just learning the spawns, predicting when people are going to come, and just having an area locked down where you can manipulate that and have people coming at you from one side and you can pick people off from behind is probably the smartest thing you can do in Call of Duty. If you guys master this, I promise you, you guys will be hitting your kill streaks and you guys will just having a more fun playing the game. You guys see it on live stream all the time. I'm literally living proof of this. I stream myself playing free-for-all, stream myself playing TDM, CTF. I'm literally expressing exactly what I'm doing in each of my gameplays that I'm playing, so you guys can see the tips and tricks are working. There's literally nothing wrong with it. I don't know who said it was wrong, but it is what it is. Those of you guys who took my advice, especially from that last video that a lot of you guys seem to enjoy, have been DM me, you know, getting V2 rockets. So yeah, let me get off that tangent. I had to just put that in this video because I know a lot of you guys were probably going to be saying about that again, but you know, that's literally how it is, how it is. That's how you play smart and that's how you get your V2. Now another tip that you guys can get into is you aren't using the weapon for that map. Now, I said this in my previous video, I'm saying it again because this is legitimately the truth. If you guys are playing on a short to medium range map, running SMGs specifically on COD World War II is going to be the most advantageous weapon to use. SMGs in this game are pretty solid. They have good range, they have good fire rates. If you have rapid fire and advanced rifling, which I recommend on nearly all of your classes, I'm telling you, you guys are going to be able to get a lot of your kill streaks and you will be able to rotate the map a lot easier. Rifles on this game are pretty good. I would specifically stick with the STG, the Eitra Burst, or even the Volk if you guys are trying to figure out a good rifle to use. Those are the three best in my opinion. That Eitra Burst is absolutely amazing. If you guys saw that Eitra Burst video I posted a couple days ago, you guys know how amazing that weapon is. I recommend you guys going ahead and checking out that class setup. Run high caliber, rapid fire, extended mag, as well as advanced rifling. You guys will be, you know, dominant with that setup. It's absolutely amazing. Now, another tip that you guys need to do is you guys don't want to count kills. And I said this previous before, but I have to reiterate because I don't know who's going to be watching this video. So if you guys are new to the channel, counting kills is the worst thing you can do on this game. Counting kills literally will freak you out. It'll get you stressed. It'll get you tense. You end up missing shots. You don't want to count, oh man, I'm two off. Oh man, I'm one off. And you end up dying. Don't do that. Just keep playing. Focus on winning every single gunfight. That should be your only thought process. Winning every single gunfight and making a smart play and outplaying your enemies. That's legitimately the only thing you should be thinking about whenever you're going for V2 rockets. I'd never ever count kills when I'm going for V2s, and I'm telling you guys, when you stop doing this, you guys will be able to hit your streaks a lot easier, they'll come a lot faster, and you guys will become all overall better players because you'll just be used to getting on high kill streaks without even knowing it. So that's definitely a tip that I would definitely keep in your disposal and something that's, you know, going to help you in the long run, especially, you know, in Call of Duty here to come. Now another tip and trick that you guys should go ahead and keep an account is you guys want to stop going for revenge kills. Now I mentioned this earlier, going for revenge kills is the stupidest thing you can do in this game because odds are the players who are killing you off those streaks are using, you know, tips and tricks that I'm saying right now. You want to come, you want to become the player that is getting people to come back to you for revenge kills, but like I'm saying, outsmarting them. People who are going for revenge kills are more than likely players that really aren't that good at the game and are getting V2 rocketed. I'm telling you guys this right now, in my V2 rocket gameplays, especially on free-for-all, you guys will see I'm killing the same guy at least 10 times in a match because he's that one player who has it, you know, in his mind, his mission to kill me off my streak. You want to train yourself to not do that and predict and, you know, start putting into a playstyle where you can start funneling enemies toward your position. You can start rotating the spawns properly and have an idea of where they're coming without them knowing exactly where you are. You'll be able to pick them off easy. Like I said, these are the players that we're feeding on. These are the players that are giving us our kill streaks. These are the players that are making us better players and increasing our KD and increasing our stats. And I'm telling you guys, this is the best way to get better at Call of Duty and hit your high streaks. Now, the final tip that I'm giving you guys for hitting your streaks and reasons why you're not hitting your streaks is because you guys need to go ahead and you guys are running the right division. If you guys are running the wrong division, you guys are definitely going to be screwed as far as getting streaks. If you guys are looking for divisions to run in COD World War II, Infantry and Expeditionary and Armored are the three best divisions to use if you're trying to get on streaks. Infantry has that stock. Expeditionary has refill with explosives and ammo, which I'm making a video on shortly because Expeditionary is absolutely amazing. And also Armored, that grenade resistance as well as toughness. You're going to be winning more gunfights. You're not going to be getting naded or stunned off your streak. So those are my seven tips and seven reasons as to why you guys are probably dying off of your high kill streaks. Let me know if these tips apply to you. Drop a like on the video, comment, subscribe. This really helped you out. I really think this video is going to help a lot of you guys out because I see a lot of guys commenting in my videos, on my live streams, and they need some explanations as to why they keep dying. This is definitely a video that's going to, I feel, help you guys out. So yeah, hope you guys did enjoy. It's been your boy Ears. Oh yeah, and also, if you guys have any other issues on the game, you guys need any more help or advice on something, comment that down in the comment section below. Whatever gets the most amount of thumbs up, I'll make a video addressing and helping you guys out. So yeah, I'll catch you guys in the next one. Deuces.
Get our flag back. Top priority. Our flag is returned. Enemy down!